So in the previous class, we were discussing class A power amplifier, okay? And we have discussed that efficiency is nothing but the output AC power divided by the input DC power, okay? Right? And we have derived the expression for the efficiency, okay? Right? The general expression for efficiency we have derived. V max minus V min into I max minus I min by 8. Okay, we have derived this in the previous class. So here, what we have is the expression for output AC power. We derived as V max minus V min into I max minus I min by 8. Okay. And efficiency is output AC power by input DC power. And thus the formula for efficiency is V max minus V min into I max minus I min by 8 into VCC ICQ. Okay. P input DC was VCC to ICQ. Output AC, we can see here. So this output AC divided by VCC to ICQ gives us the efficiency. Okay, right? Now, let us see what are the maximum. We have here V max, V min, okay, I max, I min, right? Now, if we can get these, okay, if we can get these values in terms of VCC and ICQ, then the VCC ICQ we already have in the denominator, they will get cancelled and we will get a result. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. Now the next target is to find V max minus V min in terms of VCC, I max minus I min in terms of ICQ, so that already you have VCC ICQ in the denominator, they will cancel out and we will get a result. Okay, so that is the next task. So we need to look at the graph and see what is V max, V min, I max, I min. Okay, so we are going back to the graph here. Okay, so what is V max here? V max is nothing but VCC. V min is nothing but 0. Okay, I max is nothing but 2 ICQ, I min is 0. Okay. So actually what we are doing is, we are first deriving the expression in terms of V max, V min, I max, I min. Then what we are doing, okay, for class 8, okay, for series fit direct coupled class A amplifier, we are identifying what are the V max, V min, I max, I min, and how we are going to substitute. Just now we have seen that V max was nothing but VCC. Okay, V min was 0. I max was 2 ICQ. Okay, I min was 0. Right. So substituting those values here, V max we are substituting VCC. Okay. V min is 0. So V max minus V min will be VCC minus 0. Okay, so VCC minus 0. Next, I max minus I min. I max is 2 ICQ. I min is 0. Okay, so 2 ICQ minus 0. Right. Now, further, if we simplify, VCC minus 0 is VCC, all of you know. Okay, 2 anything minus 0 is the same thing. So 2 ICQ minus 0 is 2 ICQ. Okay. Already in the denominator, we have 8 VCC ICQ. Okay. So now the VCC, VCC will cancel. ICQ, ICQ will cancel. Okay. We have 2 in the numerator, 8 in the denominator. The 2 will cancel 8 4 times. Okay. So only 1 by 4 will remain. So efficiency is 0.25. So what will be the percentage efficiency?
25%.
Very 25%. So Here, important, okay, very, very important point. What is the, okay, percentage efficiency of series FET, okay, direct coupled class A power amplifier? The answer is 25%. Okay, the answer is 25%. Okay, right. So, but there is one important thing that we have to consider, okay, that is, here, see the here we are considering the case when the signal swing is small. Okay, this is the first graph we have discussed. Then what we did, what about the case of maximum signal swing? Maximum signal swing means, okay, we are swinging along the entire load line. We are just swinging along the entire load line. Okay? Right? So, we consider two cases where any signal swing. Okay? First case. Second case. Maximum signal swing. Now, tell me the efficiency that we just derived. Is it any efficiency or maximum efficiency? Yes, just now we have derived efficiency, no? Please tell me if it is any general efficiency or if it is maximum efficiency.
Maximum.
Very good. It is maximum. Yes, correct answer. It is maximum efficiency, okay? What is the reason? Why it is maximum efficiency? Okay, the reason, see the reason is because we are considering the maximum signal swing. Okay, we are considering the maximum signal swing. That is why it is maximum efficiency. Okay, I told you the useful power. Useful power is the AC power. Okay, and we are considering maximum signal swing means we are considering the case where we have maximum output. So, in our example, suppose your father gives you 10 rupees, okay, right? And you are using maximum for beneficial purpose among that. Then obviously the efficiency that you calculate correspondingly will be the maximum efficiency, okay? Likewise, because we considered what is the maximum possible signal swing, okay? And then we derive the efficiency. The efficiency which we just got is nothing but the maximum efficiency. Okay, right? So, this is the maximum efficiency. Remember that some textbooks also call it as percentage, okay, eta max, right? Representing maximum efficiency. Okay, anyway. So, what are the advantages of this class A power amplifier? Just now we discussed, which is series FET direct coupled class A amplifier. Okay, the advantages are simple to design and implement. Okay, right. If you look at the circuit diagram, okay, the circuit diagram is very simple. Okay, the circuit diagram here. Is very simple circuit diagram. Okay. Okay, here you can see that the circuit diagram is very simple, right? Fewer number of components. It is like the minimum number of components we can use. Okay, right? For IB, we need RB. Okay? And then, of course, we need load. right? Of course, we need transistor for amplifier. Of course, we need a capacitor to isolate the DC and AC signals, okay? And of course, we need the input source. So this is the minimum, right? This is the minimum set of components that we can use, okay? So that is the reason we have the advantage, simple to design and implement, okay? Next, load is directly connected. If we see just now the circuit, okay? Just now the circuit, if we look at the circuit which we have seen just now, the load is directly connected into the circuit. So because of that, we don't need, for example, if you use transformer coupled, okay, amplifier, which we will discuss next, then we are, okay, in addition to the load, we are adding one more bulky component, transformer, okay, right? So compared to that case, here we have the load connected directly in the collector circuit, so the output transformer is not necessary, okay? So because we are not using the additional transformer, the circuit is cheaper, okay? And just now I have told you, with minimum number of components we are implementing, so less number of components are required because we are directly connecting the load to the circuit. Okay, so these are the advantages. What about the disadvantages? Okay, so the disadvantages here is, see, when we connect, okay, advantage directly connecting the load in the circuit is fewer number of components. But when we connect the load directly in the circuit, what happens is the unwanted DC power flows through the load, okay? The unwanted DC power, the unwanted DC signal flows through the load. See, it is like this. Loudspeaker, suppose. What do you want to give as an input to the loudspeaker? It is AC signal, isn't it? Okay, whatever we are talking, it is not some beep, it is not a constant signal, is it? It's a varying signal. Whatever I am speaking, it is a varying signal, isn't it? So this varying signal represented electronically, and of course amplified version of it, we need to give to the loudspeaker, not the DC signal, is it? So what happens in this particular, okay, series FET direct coupled class A power amplifier is the unnecessary DC current flows through your load, because of which there is, okay, wastage of power, right? That is one disadvantage. Another disadvantage is, suppose somebody touches the loudspeaker, okay, he or she may get shock also, right? So these are the problems associated with the direct coupled, right? Direct coupled amplifier. Okay, anyway, so because of that, power dissipation is more. Power dissipation is more. Why power dissipation is more? Because unwanted DC signal is flowing through the load. When power dissipation is more, okay, what is happening? Heat is generated. Okay, power is dissipated in any electronic, okay, circuit. What happens? The power is dissipated in the form of heat. Okay, right? So what happens there? A lot of heat is generated in the circuit, right? Now when heat is generated, it has to, we need to throw out the heat energy. If we don't throw out the heat energy, the temperature will rise continuously and the device will get damaged, okay? So to avoid that, we need to throw out the heat, okay, into the atmosphere, and in order to do that, we need to make use of heat sinks. So additionally, heat sinks are required, okay? Then, see, we cannot do impedance matching for the case of this particular amplifier, okay, because compared to the load, the output impedance is higher, okay. Whereas next case we will see that we can actually alter the load resistance, okay, reflected at the primary side of a transformer by using transformer coupling, okay. Anyway, this at present we cannot alter the load impedance. See what is okay, when do you say maximum power transfer takes place? When does maximum power transfer happen? Maximum power transfer theorem. Please tell me, when does maximum power transfer take place from source to load? When load resistance is equal to source resistance. Okay, simple words. If the resistance match, right, then the maximum power is, okay, when the maximum power is delivered to the load, okay, right. So when you consider AC signal, we are dealing with impedance. So impedance matching is very important, okay. And just now we have seen the last disadvantage, the efficiency is very poor. We got only 25%, okay, right. So what was the main reason for poor efficiency? Anybody can you answer? Why did we get this poor efficiency? What is the reason?
Large power dissipation.
Very good. Okay, correct answer. Excellent. So large power is dissipated, right? It is DC power. Unnecessary DC power is wasted. Okay, because we don't want the DC power to flow through the load, and it is happening. Okay, so if we can avoid that, definitely the efficiency will improve, isn't it? Right? So you want, everybody wants to be efficient, isn't it? Anybody try? Nobody will try. Okay, to be unsuccessful, isn't it? Everybody. Otherwise, we cannot survive. Right? So everybody wants to be successful. Likewise, when it comes to efficiency, we should try to design our circuits as efficiently as possible. Okay. So now, always in electronics, it is like this. Identify the problem. Then, how will you solve the problem? Okay. Just try to eliminate the problem. Okay. So here, what we have discussed is, okay, the problem in our circuit, okay, the problem in our circuit is that due to the unwanted DC power, okay, see what is happening in this circuit. We have VCC, we have load directly connected. The unwanted DC signal is flowing through the load. Okay. So, because of this particular coupling, DC current will flow through the load. Both, and even capacitor will allow AC. So, AC signal will come here, it will flow right in this path and then in this path. So, both the AC signal as well as the DC signal, right? Both the AC and DC currents are flowing through the load. So, the unwanted part is the DC part. So, there is unnecessary DC power lost in the load. If we can avoid that, our efficiency will improve. So, how we can avoid that? The trick is this. Instead of directly connecting the load, connect it via a transformer. Okay, instead of directly connecting a load, connect it via a transformer, and that will solve our problem. And that is what we are going to discuss next. Okay. So here, this is the circuit. Load RL, this is RL, okay, represented in the form of loudspeaker. Okay, so what we are doing here is remaining part of the circuit same. Instead of connecting the load directly here, we are connecting first a transformer, and to the secondary of the transformer we are connecting the load. Okay, so what happens here is the DC current does not directly flow through the load. Okay, isn't it? There is isolation. Okay, the DC current doesn't flow through the load. However, the DC current flows through the primary of the transformer. Okay, but the DC resistance is usually low, just the wire resistance. Okay, the coil resistance. I'm not talking about impedance, I'm talking about the resistance, the real part. It is usually a very small value. Okay, so the power lost in the primary of the transformer we can neglect, and we can simply approximate that the power lost in the load, okay, the DC power lost in the load, we can approximate it to be zero. Okay, so this is the basic idea of going for the transformer coupled, okay, transformer coupled class A power amplifier. Okay, right, so we are next going to discuss the transformer coupled class A amplifier. As we just discussed, we are connecting load resistance at the secondary of the transformer. Okay, primary of the transformer we are connecting in the collector loop. Just now we have seen. Okay, so any doubts so far, students? Students, any doubts so far?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. So here, what we have? First, let us discuss about this transformer. Anybody tell me what is turns ratio? What is turns ratio? Anybody please answer. Students, turns ratio in a transformer. Turn. See, what does transformer have?
N by N.
N1 by N2. Okay, N1 by N2, correct answer. So, we have the turns ratio as N1 by N2, okay? Turns ratio is nothing but N1 by N2, which is the number of turns on the primary. N1 is the number of turns in the primary, okay? N2 is the number of turns in the secondary. Okay, N1 is the number of turns in the primary coil. You know, transformer has two coils, primary coil and secondary coil. Okay, so N1 is the number of turns in the primary coil, N2 is the number of turns in the secondary coil, right? Then V1, voltage at primary, V2, voltage on secondary. Likewise, I1, primary current, I2, secondary current. Okay, so then, according to the transformer theory, we have the ratio of output current by input current is simply equal to the turns ratio. Okay. However, the ratio of the output voltage by input voltage is the reciprocal of turns ratio. Okay. Right. V2 by V1 is nothing but N2 by N1. For a transformer. Okay, so what happens? More number of turns, more is the voltage. Okay, for example, step down transformer, that is what we will be considering in our circuits. In step down transformer, the secondary windings, the number of turns in the secondary windings are lower compared to the number of turns in the primary winding. As a result, the secondary voltage will be lower than the primary. Okay, so this is the concept about transformer that we need for our analysis. Okay, so we know what is V1, okay, what is V2, and V2 by V1 is nothing but N2 by N1, directly proportional. V directly proportional to N, however, current inversely proportional to N. Okay, I2 by I1 will be N1 by N2, inversely proportional. Okay, fine. Next, what we will consider is, okay, all of you take pen paper. Now let us call, okay, we already have RL as the load resistance, right? See, if we have input voltage, input current, output voltage, output current, and then if we have output load, definitely there will be input resistance. Okay, so what happens actually when we connect RL at the secondary is, because of this connected RL at the secondary, because of this particular relation between the voltages and currents in a transformer, important point, please listen very carefully. Okay, the resistance, we have a resistance reflected at the input side. Okay, when we connect a load resistance at the secondary of a transformer, there is a load resistance, there is a resistance reflected at the primary. Because we are connecting RL at the secondary, a resistance is reflected at the primary. Okay, and that resistance, let us call it as RL dash. That resistance, let us call it as RL dash. So what will, okay, first of all, what will RL be in terms of V2 and I2? V2 is secondary voltage. I2 is secondary current. What will be the magnitude of RL in terms of V2 and I2?
Repeat the question.
Okay, see here, RL is the load resistance. Okay, V2 is the secondary voltage, I2 is the secondary current. So, simple Ohm's law, what is the relation between RL, V2, and I2?
V2 by I2.
RL is V2 by I2. Now, due to RL, the resistance reflected at the input side, let me call it as RL dash. Likewise, what will RL dash be?
V1 by I1.
Very good. RL dash will be V1 by I1. Okay. So now, here we have I2 by I1 as N1 by N2. V2 by V1 as N2 by N1. Okay. RL dash is V1 by I1. RL is V2 by I2. Now try to get a relation between RL dash and RL, where RL dash is the resistance reflected at the primary. Means try to get V2 by I2. In terms of V1 by I1. Find out please, what is V2 by I2 from this? How to get? See like this. I2 will be N into I1. V2 will be V1 by N. Then you do this V2 by I2. Okay? That will give you, the, okay, RL, and from that you can find RL dash. Just tell me what will be RL dash in terms of RL. RL dash is primary resistance, RL is secondary resistance. Yes, please. Take pen, paper. Practice.
RL dash is equals to 1 by n square of RL.
RL dash is 1 by n square of RL. Okay. Is it 1 by n square or n square? Please check. I think you got RL.
1 by n.
Yes, 1 by n. How 1 by n?
RL dash is equals to 1 by n of RL.
Is it? Carefully check, is it n or 1 by n?
Sir, RL is equals to 1 by n of
RL. RL is equal to 1 by n square of RL dash. Okay, so RL dash will be? RL dash will be?
1 n into RL.
N or n square?
N square into RL.
Okay, anyway, right? In simple words, if you rearrange this, or if you simplify these two equations, then V1 by I1, which is RL dash, we will get it as, N1 by N2 whole square into RL, where RL is nothing but, V2 by I2. Anyway, these are the relations relating to transformer, and I hope you already remember it, right? So, we will go ahead with our derivation part, But before we go into the derivation details, again, let us discuss where we are, or what are the conditions for this transformer coupled amplifier, Now, first, I told you that the resistance that we will consider here, we will consider it to be zero. The DC resistance. Now, why we are using transformer? Very important point. DC point of view, it will appear as zero resistance. Almost zero. Anyway, there will be some losses. But we will approximate that at for DC condition. The DC resistance here is zero. However, the AC resistance, what is the AC resistance? Tell me. What is the AC resistance here? Just now we have seen. What is the AC resistance here?
R-dash.
Very good. RL dash. So this is the trick we are doing now. DC point of view, because we are using this transformer, the DC resistance appears to be zero. AC resistance appears to be RL dash. And using this trick, we are reducing, or we are eliminating the DC power lost in the load, And that will give us the higher efficiency, So, now here, in the previous case, we had, now let us consider the DC analysis. The DC analysis, in the previous case, we had, like series FET, the series FET direct coupled amplifier, we had RL. But for DC condition, just now we are considering that this resistance is zero. If this resistance is zero, tell me, see, this is collector C, this is emitter E, What will be the relation between VCE and VCC? What will be the DC relation under DC conditions? What will be the relation between VCC and VCE? VCE means the voltage from collector to emitter, means here to ground. VCC means from this point to ground. So, we discussed that the resistance, the DC resistance here is zero. If the DC resistance at the primary of the transformer is zero, then what is the relation between VCC and VCE? Very easy question. Zero resistance means According to Ohm's law, what is the voltage drop across the primary?
VCC is equals to VC is equals to zero.
Okay, I will explain this. See here. Okay, once again, can you explain your answer? I didn't understand.
VCC is equals to VC is equals to zero.
VCC is equal to VCE. That part is correct. Okay. Anyway, what happens here? What happens here is, see, the DC resistance I told you here is zero. Okay. That is what we are considering. If this resistance is zero, the voltage drop, okay, or the potential difference. According to Ohm's law, what will be the potential difference? What will be the DC potential difference here? Students?
Zero.
Very good. Ohm's law. This resistance is zero means voltage drop across the across this. Okay. The DC voltage drop across the primary winding is zero. Voltage drop is zero. What do you mean by voltage drop is zero? Means the two terminals are at the same voltage, isn't it? Potential difference is zero. Okay, potential difference is zero means both the ends of the primary are at the same potential. Same potential means here we have VCC. So what will be the voltage here in terms of VCC? Okay. Potential difference, the DC potential difference is zero means the voltage here we get is VCC. So VCC and VCE will be, this is VCE. Now we are getting VCC here. So both the voltages will be equal. Okay. We'll continue in the next class. We are almost time is up. We'll continue in the